So in this video, I'm going to continue talking about the TV show 24. Not necessarily season 1 in particular, but overviewing the show as a whole, because I don't think I actually talked about that in the previous video. In the previous video, I did mention that, you know, 24 occurs in real time. You know, each minute in the show represents real minute in real life, which is damn cool. You know, it's one of the strongest aspects of the show. But in a way, it also kind of makes it a little bit predictable. Not predictable in what's going to happen, but the fact that something's going to happen. So, but, you know, when Jack escapes custody, you know, when Jack is forced to assassinate David Palmer in one of the situations, you know, he utilizes the, he takes advantage of the situation where, you know, the security guard gets him, and he acts like he's going to hurt the security guard to totally foil the terrorist plan. That, you just feel like, oh, wow, the crisis has been averted. But you know that there's 24 hours that this show has to show, that you know that there's 24 episodes. So I always expected, you know, if there's going to be a solution that's going to happen, I was just like, oh, what's going to go wrong this time? You know, what's going to go happen? You know, what's going to be the mess up? How are they going to continue this series, this season? You know, and that's the thing with 24, I think, is also there's the villain at the first. You think he's the main villain, but he gets taken out. And then it's like you just realize, oh, he was just a little small part of the bigger picture. You know, Gaines, I think, the villain that kidnaps Kim's daughter, Jack's daughter, Kim, and eventually also Terry, Jack's wife. You know, he seems like the main villain, but it's actually he's an underling of the Dresden brothers. And, you know, this whole situation with the terrorists, how it's a bigger conspiracy than ever. And the whole, how this whole conspiracy plays out, I think it's really interesting, but at the same time, it kind of makes you know that something is going to happen up till the very last episode. So there is that kind of predictability. Also, another thing I didn't talk about was how the show uses, like, split scenes. You know, there's this situation happening, this situation happening, this situation happening, and it shows them all at once by making split scenes. And every time it comes back from a commercial break, it usually starts with those split scenes, and you can see President Palmer handling the situation about his son. You could see Jack Bauer, like, on a strain, you know, listening to the device, or the terrorist is forcing him to do stuff. You could see Kim captured. You know, you see three scenes or four scenes sometimes at once. And when you come back, when I came back from a commercial break, I was always playing this game where it's a guessing game. It's like, I'm going to guess they're going to focus on that scene right now. So, you know, there's four scenes and then it starts going into that one particular scene. So there is also that guessing game that being played. The split scenes, I think, are particularly quite well done because you really see, you know, when you focus on that one scene, you realize that the other scenes out there, they're all occurring at the same time. You're just not being shown what happens. So you just have to kind of guess which is the most important thing that's happening right now compared to the other scenes. And so the way they did that was pretty cool, especially because all the scenes are kind of interconnected. And there's subplots as well. The subplots, I think that was particularly really interesting was, of course, President Palmer's subplot, which I didn't talk about in the previous video. His political intrigue, you know, about how his daughter was raped, and his son was very angry about that, so he went after the person who raped his sister, and ended up killing the rapist, by accidentally, of course, according to him. And that whole story was covered up by his wife and by the president's advisor. And that, you know, is an interesting situation, but the president never knew about it. And not the president, crap. I'm already thinking of David Palmer as president, but senator, president-elect. You know, he's gonna be running for president, and there's a pretty good chance that he will be running for president. But this personal story, if it leaks out, you know, Michelle Palmer, David's wife, you know, is worried that it's gonna ruin his chance for election. But David believes in honesty, so they're this, you know. having David trying to be honest and Michelle covering things up, this rivalry is really interesting play out. And it's so great to see that David Palmer is such an awesome character. He has integrity, he has authority, and he has wits. You know, he fools Michelle into thinking about the audio tape thingy. It's a very awesome way, awesome character. I think he's one of my favorite characters in the show. And he not only has that to deal with, but he also has to deal with the whole Jack Bauer situation and the terrorism situation. So it really shows his leadership skills before he becomes president. He's just a senator right now, but he really knows how to handle everything. And then seeing him just kind of break off, cut off, you know, Michelle at the end, that, you know, he's gonna now kick her out of his life. That, like, kind of shocked me, because I didn't expect to happen. Because, you know, when I think of American presidency, I can't think of any American president who was elected president without a wife, without a first lady. But that is what David's, I guess, attempting to do. And I'm thinking, like, will he get elected? Of course, as we see in season two, he does become president, which is really interesting. And of course, because the show lasts 24 hours, you know, in real time, you know, all the characters, they don't sleep, you know, and that gets me thinking why CTU doesn't have, like, ships. You know, every agency has, like, ships, you know, no one is forced to stay up 24 hours in the job, but apparently in CTU, you have to, because it's national security urgency, and no one sleeps. So that's an interesting thing to consider, I think. One last thing before I end this video is just on Terry Bauer. Not just her going amnesiac after the car accident thing and the whole, I don't know. They tried to keep the whole situation with Kim and Terry. It was really intense when they were kidnapped and as they were trying to escape, you know, Goins. But after that, I don't know. It just kind of felt like, really, they're going to get kidnapped again? Really, this happens to them again? It just felt so unreal. Of course, after it becomes revealed that Nina is the mole, not you can connect the dots and see why it's like that. But still, when I was watching it without that realization, it was just like, you know, I don't really get the point. I didn't really get the suspense. Plus, the character that portrayed Terry Bauer, I didn't like her acting at all. I thought it was pretty awful, especially when she gets really hysterical and kind of angry, you know, when she meets Nina and it's the debriefing time. She gets really, really moody. Of course, maybe that's because she just found out that she's pregnant, and she just found that Nina was sleeping with Jack when they were separated, and all these kind of realizations that she has. But still, like, she just came off to me as a very hard to like character. So I really feel bad for this. But when she, you know, at the very end, what happens to her in the end? You know, I really didn't feel that much emotion, as the show would have wanted me to. And it even tried to do that flashback sequence with showing, like, black and white Jack and Terry happy together. But I don't know, the whole, because 24 shows the present, has always shown the present, showing that flashback sequence, which, you know, hasn't ever been shown before in the previous episodes, didn't really give me that emotional connection. So, and it also, it ties really well. As a plot device, Terry's death acts as a really good tying device to Season 2. So that's really all I have to say about 24 Season 1. So, yeah.